Okay, so have you seen? Boleh nampak?
Yes.
Okay, so this example given. Okay, so within with this, we have also we have the tutorial, tutorial on this example. Okay, first we have to look at in this example first. So for the example one here, for the ATJ 5/85 Amendment 2013. So this is a example. To have the thickness for every layer that we have in our pavement. We have the subbase, subbase, base, we have the road surface there, we have the binder cost, and then we have the rolling cost here. Also, yang, okay, so yang at the first here is have the traditional pavement with granular base. So we have to design this with the pavement with the granular base. We add a lot of the material that have to construct our materials or our pavement that shown in a figure given in this slide. Okay, so you had a lot the figure and okay, so I mean this is a figure, yeah? Granular base, tabular base, concrete and so on. So for this example is for the granular base. Okay, so design a road pavement for a two-lane highway with an average daily traffic, which is a ADT of the 1,350 vehicles. Okay, so 16% of the which are commercial vehicle with unloaded unloaded weight more than 1.5 tons. Okay, so this is just design a road pavement for two-lane highway. So with every daily traffic is a 1,350, it mean one lane there. Okay, so step one, you have to develop of design input. Traffic count data indicate a total 2,700 vehicles in both direction. We have two lane, so one direction 1,350. Okay, so both lane is a 2,700 vehicles. So this is observation here is a one direction 24-hour period. So dalam masa 24 jam. If the design is based on the traffic data from the highway planning unit survey, the result based on the 16 hours survey, usually 6 to 22 hours should be multiplied with 1.2. So for this example, this is a survey 24-hour period. So one lane is a one direction is a 1,350. Okay, no need to multiply by 1.2. Okay. Until there, have any problem or not? Ada masalah tentang penerangan saya sehingga pada itu. Okay, jalan ni dua lane, highway dua lane, satu lane kita ada 1,350. So dalam di survey dalam masa 24 jam. So maknanya untuk contoh ini, for this example, no need to multiply by 1.2. Is it clear? Boleh ya? Okay, the following. Saya bersama awak ke tak ni? Okey lagi? Dengar?
Ya, yes, yes.
Okey.
Dengar.
Okey, sorry. So, sebab takut nanti terputus lagi. Okey, the following additional project related information is available. So, percentage of the commercial vehicle here is a 16%. It given from the question lah. No detail breakdown by the vehicle type. It means dia tak pecahkan. It's not a breakdown every commercial vehicle. So dia tak ada di situ CV1, CV2, CV3 is don't have that. So just use the percentage commercial vehicle, just 16%. Okay. So lane distribution factor, one lane, one direction. So you have to refer the table 2.2 there. So the lane distribution factor now is a one lane in one direction. You mean you have two lane, two direction. So it mean one lane, one direction is a L equal to 1. Refer the table 2.2. And train factor, so train ni adalah rolling, types dia adalah rolling. So from the table 2.3, it have 1.1. So this data is given from the question lah, it given the train factor is rolling. We have the two lane highway, one direction is one lane. So that's given from the question. And then design life is a, usually is a 20 years lah. And annual traffic growth is a 4%, it given from the questions. Okay, now the step two, you have to calculate the ASL, which is the equivalent standard ASL for the base year or the first year after we construct the roads. Okay, so the ASL for the base year equal to average daily traffic times 365 days per year. You have the 365 days time percentage of the commercial vehicle. So we use this 3.7 because this is a commercial vehicle mix. It's not divide by the types of CV1, CV2 and so on. So it's a mixed commercial vehicle. So we use the 3.7 here. Okay, and then times LEF. Okay, LEF here is 1 given from there. Okay, so 1. And then, So 3.7 is here. LEF is 3.7 and times L, L in distribution tadi, kita dapat from the table, we form from the table, is 1 times then the trend factor is 1.1. Okay, is it clear from here, from the formula into the have you put the data here? Boleh ya?
Yes.
Okay, so we have the percentage of the commercial vehicle is 16%, so it means 0.16 lah. Okay, so jangan silap letak 16 di sini, so 16 per 100 it means percentage, so 0.16 or 16%. Okay, and then we have the ASL here is 0.321 million. Okay, so for our design traffic here is 20 years. Okay, so ASL for the design traffic here is 20 years. So ASL times dengan the total or the total growth factor, TGF here is 29.78. It come from here lah. So we have the annual growth rate is 4% from the questions. And then design period is 20. Then the total TGF or total growth factor is 29.78. And then from that you have 9.56 million. So refer the table 2.5 here. So the T or traffic category here is a T3 because it's a here. Okay. So 9.56 million. Okay. So we have the traffic category T3. Okay. Step seterusnya, step 3 is determine after we have the T traffic category, we have to find the determine subgrid strength. So it come from the, this is a result from the subgrid testing lah. So before we have this value, so this is testing is we have to doing at our site lah. So CBR mean is 18.5%. CBR standard deviation is 4.4% and probability 85%, normal divide is 1.282. So the characteristic CBR value used for design is you have to use the formula lah, mean minus or design input value equal to mean minus normal divide times standard deviation. So the mean here is 18.5 minus normal divide is 1.282 and 4.4 is a standard deviation and you have 12.9%. So refer from there, so 12.9% here. Okay, the range is here. So the SG is a SG2 from this table. Okay, and then step 4, the example there. So this is a the combination of the thickness there lah. So we have the T3 and then SG2. You have to refer the figure from there. So figure 3.3 here. So this is a design here. So before that, you have to check the minimum thickness for the combination of the bituminous surface. So we have the binder cost and we have the wearing cost there. So combined thickness of the bitumen layers is 18 centimeters. This is a, you have to check with the table 2.1 conceptual outline of the pavement structure. Okay, so the answer is between here and T3 and then this is a pavement structure here. So supposed to the combination of the thickness of the bitumen layers should be 18 centimeters. Okay, so the material that you have is a granular base. So this is a 50 plus 130 mm. So we have the 18 centimeter or 180 mm. Okay, and then CAB is a crushed aggregate base and then G is a granular sub base. So we have this thickness. So it means that the our thickness or our pavement thickness there should be from the subgrade, we have the sub base 20 centimeter. We have the base is 20 centimeter also, and we have the binder cost is 130 or 13 centimeter, and then it's a surface is a wearing cost is a 50 centimeter. Okay, so this is a what we have here. Okay. Until here, have any problem or not? Okay tak? Hello? Plus?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, okay, okay.
Cuma kena tengok banyak lagi.
Yeah. Supposed to you have, we need the traffic category here. So how to have the traffic category here and then have the SG there. Okay, traffic category come from here. Okay. Okay, so traffic categories, you have to have calculate the ASL for the first year and the ASL for the design period is 20 years. Okay, this is given from the question lah. So given 20 years and then we have to have that. So this is T3. Okay, and then how and then the SG. And then combination of that, so you have to refer the figure T3 SG2. So you have to look at the it has the several types, but now the question is example is a granular base. That's why we choose here granular base. And then supposed to it is just enough layer. This is check for the minimum thickness of the combined of the layers here. Okay, so now we look at on the example two. Example two is a design a road pavement for 4-lane freeway. Concession the toll road with an average daily traffic is 7,286 vehicle. Of the 20% are commercial vehicle. So it means from the daily traffic here, so 20% from that is a commercial vehicle.
Sorry, this look. Ada dua orang nak masuk.
Oh, dia tak nak masuk.
David, oh, so 5 minutes. Okay.
Tak nampak. Okay. Dah masuk kot
sudah.
Okey. Okey, untuk contoh yang kedua ni, yang contoh kedua ni, for the second example here, the average daily traffic is 7,286 vehicles, but it's a 20% from here is a commercial vehicle. And then from that, it have ADT based on the highway planning unit survey from 6 to 20. So maknanya, we observe ni, it's not for 24 hours. This is observed from the 6 to 22 hours. Okay, initial daily traffic, the average should be based on the minimum 3 days, 24 hours per day. If traffic count cover time period of the 6 to 22 hours, multiply the traffic count reported by highway planning unit with a factor of 1.2. So you have to multiply 1.2 here. Okay, so from here, 7,000, 20% is a commercial vehicle. And then also is a separated, the commercial vehicle is not mixed commercial vehicle, but you have the CV1, CV2, CV3 and CV4. And then observation between this is not 24 hours, that's why you have to multiply by 1.2 here. Okay, until here, have any questions? Yeah, need to refer equation 2, page 10, because the site specific distribution of traffic by vehicle type is available. CV1, CV2, CV3 and CV4. Okay, so this that you have here, from here. Okay, so have any problem until here?
No.
Okay?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, now, so we have the CV1 commercial vehicle is 624 vehicles. You have to time 1.2 because of the it's not the 24-hour observation, so that's why. Then we have here CV1 is a 749. We have the CV2 is a 547, and so on. This is from the observation. We multiply here because the observation is not 24 hours. That's why we have this value lah. Okay, so now the lane distribution factor L equals to 0.9, two lane in one direction. So we have the four lane here, two direction. So one lane is a two, one direction is two lane. And then I refer the table 2.2 here. So the two lane in one direction, so dia punya lane distribution factor ni adalah 0.9. Boleh? So you have to refer the table lah ni. Okay, so with you, you have that table kan? You look at your table there, and then you look at on the two lane in one direction that you find is a 0.9. Is it correct? Betul kan? Is it correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, and then train factor dia kata train dia. So ini adalah soalan ni, kalau sepatutnya selengkapnya dia adalah dia punya types of terrain. So this is a flat terrain. So train factor from the table there is the flat is a T equal to 1. Design life is a 20 years. And then assume annual traffic growth rate is a 4.5%. The R is a 4.5%. And now next step is a have to calculate. The first you have to calculate the equivalent standard error for the first year. Base year equal to the average daily traffic is say come from the previous. Okay, we have the previous is 749, is it? And now you have to look at the LEF, load equivalent factor, from the table 2.1 here. Base for the CV1 is a LEF is a 0.1. So that's why we have here. Okay, so for the ADT CV2, you have to tie there, and then you have meter the end. So previous there you have the 547 and LEF is a, so for the CV2 LEF is a 4. That's why you have 4 here. And so on. Okay, so this is a CV3, LEF3 is a 4.4. And then for the CV4, we have 1.8. And this is a times 365 times L times T. Okay? Okay. So until here is it okay? How to have this? Okay, eh? Boleh?
Okay.
Okay. And then we have 1.363 million for the ESL for the first year or the base year here. And then for the design traffic over 20 years, so equal, this is from the formula lah. So we have the ESL for the first year, 1.363 million time. So we have 1 plus R square N. So new 1, this is a 4. R is a 4.5% here, okay? And then we have the 20 years and the minus. $42.7 million. This come from this formula. ESL is a 1.363, R is a 4.5%, N equal to 20. This is 4.5%. Okay, so that you have the 42.7, and then you have to refer the 42.7 from the table. Okay, and you look at the table. Okay, here, right? No, here. Okay, here. Okay, we have the tadi, we have the 42.7 million kan, it mean the traffic category adalah T5 lah. Okay, boleh kan?
Boleh.
Okay. Fine. And now we have to calculate the SG lah. You have to know the SG. So from and then this is example is a given you. Your subgrade testing say in this value lah. Okay, tadi ni dalam bentuk percentage. So now is a result modulus or mean modulus lah. So we have the modulus or mean modulus here is a 165 megapascal. Standard deviation is 28 megapascal. Reliability 95%. Normal deviation is a minor is a 1.645. So it means the design input value from this formula. So we have the 165, the mean minus the normal deviation is a 1.645, and times 28 megapascal. So this the standard deviation here. Okay, you have the 119 MPa. Okay, 119 MPA. So subgrade category is SG3 from this table lah. Okay, so note the use design input value from the table 2.6 equal to 119 plus 119 here plus the mean here 165. So lebih kurang lah. So nearest to 140. So okay, for the design input is 140 also, and then the SG is SG3. Is it okay?
Okay.
If you want relativity, it's a 95%. It says you have to use this formula, je. Okay. It's not given to you, so you have to use the value here. Just then the normal divide, 1 or 0 here. So based on the reliability, probability given lah. Boleh.
Boleh.
Okay. Okay. Now that you have tadi kita we have the T5 and SG3, is it? Eh? So kita ada T5, traffic category is T5, and then we have the subgrade category SG3. Okay, you have to check the minimum thickness lah. Okay, so now, so our pavement structure is T5 kan? So traffic category ni adalah T5, and then you have to look at that. So for the combination thickness of the bitumen layers, it means we have the wearing cost and bending cost. Okay, at least 24 cm. Boleh? Okay. So for the crusher aggregate road base, CAB, so 20 cm. And then for the subgrade, for the subgrade CBR is a 15 cm. Okay, now you have to refer the figure from the ATJ amendment 2013 there, T5 SG3. Okay, so we have, so the first, when we use the granular base, okay, you have to check here. So this is a T5 and then SG3. So you have to look at and these rows. Okay. Now the combination here should be at least 24 centimeter or 240 millimeters. So this is okay. And then this is the requirement is okay. So can use this. Or you can use this. Okay. So this is a we call the full depth asphalt concrete base. So it means the base also using the asphalt. Okay, so that's why. Okay, look at on the first choice first. Okay, the first option here. So there, so we have the 50 and then this is for the option one here. Okay, and then option two is here. So the option two here is using the full depth asphalt concrete base. It means we have the base and the binder cost, and then the base cost, the base, we have the asphalt. It means we call the full depth asphalt concrete base. So for option two here, if you mean surface cost, either the AC10 or AC14 is a 50 centimeter, and then we have bituminous binder cost combination with the road base is a 200 millimeters or a 20 centimeter, and then divide there. So kita separate lah. So kita ada binder cost is a 60 centimeter, and we have the road base is 140. Combination here is a 200 millimeter, and then we have the granular set base is a 150 centimeter. Okay, so note here, if the asphalt binder and base cost mixture are based on the same type of the binder and aggregate gradation, the thickness of the binder and the base cost are interchangeable. So this is instead of the 6 cm for the binder cost and the 40 cm base cost, it can also 10 cm binder cost and 10 cm cost base cost. Okay, untuk type yang ini, yang pertama tadi, we have, so ini tak guna asphalt. Okay, so for this is using the asphalt also. That's why we have here the road base here, we use the bituminous atau bitumen. So we call the full depth asphalt concrete base, and then combination thickness ni adalah inilah. Okay, ada soalan tak?
Sir, okay. Macam mana kita nak tahu dia punya level layer dia 140 dengan 60 tu?
Yang ni.
Yeah.
Yang ini kalau dia boleh either, maknanya kita sendiri yang akan letakkan di situ. Tapi normalnya biasanya gitu. Kalau kata ni dibagi 10-10 pun boleh juga. Yang ini maknanya kita punya atas kita. Atas kita. So untuk ini dia ada juga nanti kita kena tahu sebab tak boleh yang ini nipis sangat. Untuk menampung kan dia ada kriteria lain juga. Tapi biasanya inilah yang dia combine combination ni.
So 60-140.
So 60, maknanya 200 itu. Ataupun letak 10-10 pun boleh. So mengikut note di sini lah. Boleh. Kalau ini, if asap binder and base cost mixture are based on the same type of binder and ingredient. Ini. Tapi kalau kata soalan tu, it given to you, dia kata ni bukan-bukan and then dia ada keadaan lain lah. Tapi kalau yang ni, so kita boleh tukar-tukar begitulah. Satu. Satu yang ni tadi, yang ni kalau dia kata dia suruh you design is a asphalt, full depth asphalt base, maknanya kena pilih type inilah. Tapi kalau dia kata tidak, it's not full depth, okay, asphalt concrete, so you kena choose lagi. So you have to look at the questions.
Alright, sir.
Okay. Yang lain okay? Okay, option ketiga atau yang ketiga, yang ni adalah dia guna. So this is a use the polymer modified asphalt, okay? So SMA 14 instead of the 50mm unmodified. So tadi yang kita guna 5 cm or 50mm tu using unmodified bitumen. So yang ni option 3 ni, it have that we modified our bitumen, okay, with the polymer. Okay, so can use this category or this layer lah. Okay, the thickness layer here. Boleh. So also, but this is special purpose surface cost, which is the we using the modified bitumen with the SMA 14 here. Okay, so kita ada ini lah tadi. Ini. So this is 50 with the polymer modified asphalt 50mm, and then we have the ini tadi combination of the BC or BB by the cost dan juga base tadi kita ada 160. And then we have 130 with the PMA. You boleh combine yang ni atau you yang ni. So this is a how to choose lah. Boleh? Okay. Okay, until that, have any questions? Tak ada ya? Okay, now we look at on the, this is example 3. This is for the low volume road. Design a pavement for two-lane road, a rural road in a year. Okay, the traffic volume over the design period between the 100 to 500,000. Okay, so here given already, and the CBR is a 5 to 12%. CBR 5 to 12%, and then this is 100 to 500,000 lah. The axle here, so we have to choose here lah. So option one, select from table 4.1. Between surface cost is a 50mm or 5 cm. Example 1 tadi begitu. So this is a, for example 3, it's a low volume road. So using that, so kalau you tengok sini, it don't have the only one layers of the bitumen surface. Dia tak ada two layers kan? Faham tak? So this is for the low volume roads. Okay, and then you have to check lah. Also, you have to check lah the thickness for the combination of that is a 5 cm. So it's a 5 cm. It's okay lah. And so on there. Okay, this is a tadilah selection of table 4.1. So bitumen surface cost is a 50. So ini is a previous. This is a explanation from the previous lah. Okay, so this is for the low volume road pavement. So this is a design period here. So tadi 100 to 500,000. Okay, so that you have to choose there. So this is CBR value. So this is for the low volume road pavement. As though we have the CBR and then we have the. So no need to have the category of the traffic lah. Okay. Or you can use select conventional flexible pavement. We're going to base from the figure 3.1. So we have the T1 and then we have the SG1. T1 is the volume of the traffic is there lah, 100 to 500,000. Okay, so use that. So we have the types of here lah. So this is using the global base. Okay, so this. Okay, boleh? So that's macam mana kita nak dapatkan. So hari ni tadi kita tengok tadi how to have the traffic category T and then the SG types SG, okay, and how to choose the thickness for layers from the figure given from the manual ATJ 5/85 amendment 2013. Have any questions? Ada soalan tak?
Saya no, sir.
Okay, so yang lain saya sekali lagi saya highlight for this example. Tadi kita how to have the T and then how to have the SG and then untuk itulah untuk and then how to use the thickness from the figure given to you in manuals. Itu je lah untuk slide yang ini. Boleh? Aiman Razi Aiman.
Ya, tu saya.